December the 14th of my practice diary, my progression journey, after a rather sober, shall I say, sharing yesterday. Today I've spent a very focused day. I think what happened yesterday was various things, but one particularly that I tried to do too much. I was overambitious and had not clocked my emotional state and what I'd set out to do. And I think one word that came up for me at the end, which I think I might have written, but I am very uncompromising. But in realizing that I push myself too hard as I build my layers of skin to an extent to make me more courageous and less fragile when tackling tasks. So anyway, today is a complete contrast because I've been entrusted to put together a short compilation of music for a friend as a gift. And so he wanted very much for it to be on the sax, and I've really, really enjoyed having a very purposeful way, although I will say the downside of living in Lincolnshire is the constant, well, not constant, but it just happens at various times of the day that the RAF are doing all sorts of flight stuff. So I've been kind of dodging, listening out for when it's coming or when it's going so that I can hit record. So it's something that I enjoy. Actually, it's just coming at the moment, you can probably hear it. But it's something that I enjoy really doing, and that's threading music together. The remit was that the gift was for my friend's wife, who is not particularly, she likes music, but is sort of has a very sort of, you know, varied taste, and therefore all the snippets should be quite short. So I've been kind of thinking about this all week, actually, or all 2 weeks since I was first asked, and I was thinking, well, home recorded, still recoiling from that, although got much better with that. You can hear the RAF. Really will be a disaster for a commercial recording in Lincolnshire, that unless it's completely soundproof. Anyway, I got distracted. So the brief was very clear, little snippets, and I love putting these things together because if I show, I'm going to do it rather crudely. I'm going to pick up the stand and show. Hopefully you're seeing all the music cabinet open. I hope that's come out correctly. So I'm sort of searching through and pulling together things, playing bits of things and then sort of coming together. And that's really what we as musicians are all about, being flexible, being adaptable. So actually it's been a really fulfilling time. But I think the other thing which I'd sort of spoken about but might have got a bit lost yesterday in the warm-up in terms of our being fit for purpose is that we have a warm-up that if we are put on the spot, I often compare it to the state of military personnel. Obviously, having spent 8 years as clarinet and saxophone professor for the Royal Military, one of the most fulfilling teaching and mentoring times of my career, I will say. It was such a terrific time, and to meet such varied musicians and individuals. And I sort of really got as much as any civilian can into the psyche of why at the one side the musicians were obviously doing their musical training, while at the other side the strictness of, you know, all the military related duties and fitness that was so fundamental to their job. And it was then that I realised that us musicians, whether we're professional, whether we're amateur, we have to be fit for purpose. And I think that's my deep commitment to my warm-up, which I has evolved over a period of time. I've got a different warm-up for the sax, which involves many of traditional Londex and Marcel Mule. There's another book which actually I use, which I find incredibly useful, which the name eludes me at this moment, but I'll bring it into a later diary. And Russia, some of those wonderful, wonderful, sort of great for stamina, never mind anything else. And actually today, as I was doing my crabwise scales, I did remember the altissimo register, a retrieval of the fingering. But, you know, whether it's on clarinet, whether it's on sax, whether it's our related instruments, that we are fit for purpose, because in the military sense, we never know when we're going to be called for duty. And therefore, having a carefully formulated and trusted warm-up to which we know that our not only our viability and our reliability is dependable, but also confidence. Because if we have confidence in the warm-up, which comprises of all the various intricacies that are demanded of us. So mine is formulated specifically on the sax, a lot for the left hand, because that, as a primary clarinet player, is always a slight curiosity. And at the same time, the low notes, at the same time, vibrato, at the same time, the focus of tone. And being really, really aware of what we are doing. And this awareness is so crucial. And that's where the sort of daily monitoring of a warm-up allows us to sort of focus, whether it's on the mouth and the difference of the mouth with the B-flat clarinet or the E-flat clarinet or the alto sax or the bass clarinet or the tenor sax, that we have a really clear understanding and awareness of these finite differences and the regulation that needs to be done, the oral facial, the focus, and all of that. And certainly, as my OPC, Organise Prioritise Commit YouTube channel progresses, I will have specific educational and films where I talk about little aspects, particularly as a doubler, which I can share and hopefully help support and give courage to those doubling players. But so back today, so I've linked it all together. I've sort of uploaded them all onto Audacity, and now I'm going to pull it all together. The last one that I did was one of Jim Ray's jazz studies, number 18. And I was so aware with this how much the visual attention, I've learnt it and recorded it in a short space of time. And I was really aware of how looking is so crucial, because if we look too far ahead, we stumble. If we don't look far ahead enough, we stumble. So where the visual attention is, and we can get so easily caught up, get distracted with the mouth or get distracted with the fingers. But so often we've got our various attentions, which I often talk about, visual, oral, kinesthetic, being the sort of the three crucial. I won't want to digress there, but it's certainly something that I talk a lot about, and how we divert the different attentions all the time. But visual attention to me is the prompt that then gets the physical, the kinesthetic, the fingers. Anyway, it's been a fulfilling afternoon. It's easy for me at this point, feeling more purposeful to push things too far. And so once I've put this all together, it's all recorded, clarinet probably won't get now a play, because I've been actually playing most of the afternoon. So I'm going to let my mouth rest, but it's been a very productive playing and very purposeful. And to be honest, just reminds me how important daily practice is. But another thing, which is really quite simple, that how much I love playing and how much I feel so committed to music.